Namaste. Hamesha khush raho bitiya. I am JVN Dr. Anamika Ahirwar, Associate Professor in the Department of Science and Technology at Jayoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur. Today I am going to take the lecture on the subject named Data Warehousing Data Mining, and the today's session is on Data Warehousing Architecture. Let's start. These are the topics which I have covered in this lecture. Data Warehouse Architectures. First is Data Warehouse Architecture. It is a basic architecture. And the second is Data Warehouse Architecture with a staging area. Third is Data Warehouse Architecture with a staging area and data marts. Fourth is three-tier architecture of data warehouses. These are basically the four types of data warehouse architectures. Let's start. First architecture is data warehouse architecture. It is a basic architecture. Data warehouse are their architecture vary depending on the specific of the organization situations. There are basically three common architectures, as I have told you. First is the basic data warehouse architecture. Here you are seeing this diagram. In this figure, a simple architecture for a data warehouse is shown in this figure. End users directly access data derived from several source systems through the data warehouse. The figure illustrates basically three things. First is data stores. Data stores can be operational systems and flat files. Data warehouse. Second is in this metadata, summary data and raw data. And the third is users, that is analysis, reporting and mining. This figure displays the metadata and raw data of the standard OLTP method, that is online analytical processing method, as is the additional type of data, summary data. Summaries are very useful in data centers as they pre-computed long-term operations in advance. For example, a standard data warehouse query is to retrieve sales like August. A description is Oracle is referred to as a materialized view. Next, come to the second architecture with a staging area. In this figure, you need to clean and process your operational data before putting it into the warehouse. You can do this programmatically, although most data warehouses use a staging area instead. A staging area simplifies building summaries and general warehouse management. This is the third type of data warehouse with staging area and data marts. Although the architecture of the figure is quite common, you may want to customize your warehouse architecture for different groups within your organization. You can do this by adding data marts, which are systems designed for a particular line of business. This figure illustrates an example where purchasing, sales and inventories are separated. In this example, a financial analyst might want to analyze historical data or purchases and sales. This figure illustrates five things. First, data stores, that is operational systems and flat files. Second, it is staging area. In this, where data sources go before the warehouse. Third one is warehouse. In this, metadata, summary data and raw data. Fourth is data marts. In this, purchasing, sales and inventories. And the fifth and last one is users. In this, analysis, reporting and mining. Okay, thank you so much for listening me. And this session is powered by digital version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. Hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in comment box. I will resolve you. Thank you.